Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to do something with gold and gemstones, so I figured let's just think of what would happen. I look so unnatural that my camera doesn't even recognize my face as a face anymore. But anyway, point is, what would happen if jewelry would melt and somehow not be scalding hot, because that would be painful, and then get splattered onto your face. And this is what I imagined with that whole prospect. I just had a lot of fun painting this. I hope you'll enjoy watching it, so let's get started. Go to the eyes first, just so that I can still touch my face while doing my eyeballs, you know, without ruining any face makeup. I'm going to prime them first with my usual concealer and powder method. I'm not actually sure if the powder stuff I'm going to use in the rest of my face. Well, it says that the powder isn't supposed to be used inside the eyes, obviously. But I'm not sure if that will actually be, you know, useful on my eyelids. So just to be safe, I'm going to use cream eyeshadows. These ones are very budget friendly by Catrice. This is California Creamin' and this is Champagne Shower. Just going to apply the palest color in the inner corners, both the top and bottom, and then the darkest on the outer corners, obviously. Don't worry about the edges of this stuff, because, you know, it's just supposed to be there to paint it gold, and then other than that, it's just going to have to blend with this stuff. However, what I'm going to do first now is actually do my, like this part of my face, my forehead, yeah, the top of my forehead with foundation, and also the bottom part of my face. I'm not actually sure where I want the gold splatter to be. So I'm just going to do that first and add powder to it. Then I'm going to map out the splatter with a gold eye pencil. You can also use a white eye pencil or a very faint gray one. You know, whatever works. The only thing is, you know, it's very useful if it disappears once you start applying this. So don't use deep black, because you're going to remain seeing that. Then I'm going to shade first, because that's just easier before I paint it, because otherwise the shading is going to go over the paint and yeah, it's just annoying. So I'm going to use a pale taupe shade first, and then for the deeper parts move to a darker taupe shade. Do always remember for your painting from which direction the light is coming. I usually just pick, you know, directly upwards, because that's easy to remember. Then for the gold, I'm going to use this powder and I'm going to mix it with water. They actually recommend using Mehron mixing medium, but water is cheaper, so I'm going for water, and I'm just going to fill in my splatter. Okay, pro tip, don't use too much water, otherwise you'll just get faintly gold water dripping down your face. I probably could have thought of that myself, but I didn't. But I found out anyway. So yeah. This effect really reminds me of when I, with oily skin, Don't moisturize my face before applying makeup, then don't bother powdering it, and then go jogging or do whatever that makes me sweat. Looks better than the oiliness though. To just define it a little bit more, I'm going to shade below the splatter with the dark taupe shade and a very tiny eyeshadow brush. I think I was holding the wrong side up, but anyway. And I'm doing the same on top, but then I'm going on top of the masking splatter with the pale cream eyeshadow. Then I'm going to use a gold liquid lipstick on my eyelashes and waterline. I do want to make sure that it's eye safe this time. So I'm using one by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. On my lips, I'm going to use a dark nude lipstick. I was on the fence for a moment about adding lashes or not, but I really want to keep the effect as if jewelry randomly melted and got splattered on my face. Because that's a normal thing. So I'm going to use a little bit of black eyeshadow instead, just to make my eyes stand out a little bit more. Then for the gems, you could go two different paths. You could go the lazy path, like I'm going to. Or you could go the path of the lots of different tiny rhinestones and liquid latex, which I've done in the past. This time I wanted to go for the easy way and use this sort of like pre-made thing of rhinestones. This one is, I think it's meant for like festivals and such, which means that if you want to do something like this for Halloween, for example, you can easily probably get it for cheaper between the festival season and the Halloween season. Just saying. But yeah, there's been lots of different shapes and sizes all over the internet. I'm going to use one with a little bit of purple. Okay, I do feel that there's something stuck on my forehead, because there is, obviously. So I am going to try to not make too many facial expressions, because I do feel as if that would sort of make it go loose sooner. However, I think on the bright side, like it's not very uncomfortable or anything. I'm just used to moving my face around a lot. I do actually think that you could reuse this by just cleaning it well once you take it off and then next time applying it with liquid latex. Or you could just take the rhinestones off singularly and just reuse those. So that's it, the final result. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. And if you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. If you want, you can also subscribe to my channel. I occasionally, like, well, once every 2 weeks or so, I do something fun like this. Most of my tutorials, however, are actually wearable. Below the video, as always, you can find a full list of all the products I put on my face today, like the cool color code names, stuff like that, just all the details. And you can also find all my social media accounts and names down there. I'm mostly active on Instagram. I always share it there as well whenever I upload a new video onto my YouTube channel. So I'd really love it if you'd want to follow me there. Other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!